Hello, guys. Good morning. So today we are going to discuss the other things like as part of the introduction of this Linux. So we are actually making small videos and which will help you to at least read one particular video per day. So the video length is going to be hardly 30 to 40 minutes. Okay, so I'm trying to make it much easier and also small, so that one person, if he or she will read that 40 or 30 minute video per day, then maximum within this 1 month or 1.5 month, he or she will learn this particular self-scripting course. So let's just recap the previous sessions. We have just covered the history of the Linux and what is the computer hardware and software and the shell. So today we are going to discuss that what are the features of Linux, so that Linux is being very popular and why the people should use Linux. Okay. So here I have written very easily, that very small points also there, like Windows code is with a Microsoft company only, not shared by anybody. Licensing is very costly and you have to use the license copy in the company. So if you have a company or you are buying one new laptop, then you must have the original version of the Windows. So you might have listened from the that shopkeeper that if you are buying one laptop with the original version of the Windows, then you have to pay another 5,000 for the original copy. So Windows is actually costly. If you are installing any Windows operating system in your system, then you have to pay. And in company, there is no chance of using the pirated Windows copy. So in company, it is bound to buy the Windows product, Windows operating system, and it's a purchase version. So you have to purchase. Again, whatever software if you want to install in your Windows operating system, then that software is also going to be by you. Okay, so everything so Windows is going to give you only Windows operating system, then other software you have to buy, then also for security reason you have to buy one antivirus in your Windows operating system. A lot of things you have to spend as part of the beginning setup of your system. But Linux is open source. As I told, it's free to use, no need to pay any licensing fee. So many middle level companies in the world, in Pune, I know many companies in the like Banner and Aund, some very small companies, they are using the free software of Linux. Okay. And many of the companies are also surviving because of this operating system cost is very high. If you are installing the particular operating system in your server, then really it is very high. So after Linux, then many companies are using this Linux as an operating system. Okay. Then secure means I will tell one difference between Windows and Linux that will better understand by you. In Linux, actually, somebody sometimes telling that Linux is virus free, it is totally wrong. Linux may affected by virus. Suppose virus is coming to Linux, then Linux is also welcome to the virus also. Okay. So in Windows, if any type of virus is coming, then that is immediately going to be spreaded over all the folders present in Windows. Suppose I have a C drive, then under the C drive, many other folders like program files, then Windows, then documents and system, lot of folders are there. So each folder contains some subfolder, then again some subfolder like this. Suppose your Windows contain 1 lakh folder. Okay, let's say then all the 1 lakh folders are going to be affected by the virus if one virus come to a particular folder. That means easily the particular virus is going to be replicate among all the folders. But the same virus, if it is coming to the Linux, Okay, then that line, that particular virus is going to be remain in that particular folder, that is not going to be automatically replicated to other folders. This is the nature of Linux. So if any virus is coming to a particular folder, then that is not being replicated. So it will be within that particular folder. So if you are able to know that, yes, I have a virus, then you just go to that particular folder and delete that, right? Instead of deleting the one folder, one particular virus from many folders, you can just delete, right? So using the rm command, even you can delete a particular virus in Linux. Okay, there is a very simple method to delete, but in Windows you have to install the antivirus for deleting. I am not telling that in Linux also antivirus is not required. Yes, if you have a small scale industry and you have a development environment, then there is no need of all the antivirus kind of thing. You just you just take that free software of Linux and just do your development. If some virus is coming, then you can easily delete. And Linux is very secure because everywhere there is a security file label, data label, then the folder label, then the block label, then a hard disk label. So disk label, so everywhere there is a security, but in Windows that much security you will not get. For security, you have to purchase the products, okay? So each time you have to spend a lot of money for secure your Windows system from the outside world. And specifically I am using the Linux operating system in one of my laptop, and in another laptop there is a Windows, but in Windows there is a antivirus compulsory, but till now I didn't buy any antivirus for the Linux. And this Linux system I am using in internet, but in Windows system hardly I am using in internet. Okay, if I am anything required I want to connect to the internet, then always I am connecting the Linux laptop to the internet. So till now I never seen any type of issue in my Linux OS, but Windows laptops within this 4 years I have formatted 4 times because of virus. Okay, then for hackers also it is not easy task to hack the Linux system, because they have to learn commands, and it is a very small thing, but anyway I can tell this is a difference. But in Windows easily a hacker can enter into that particular system. Then simplified update for all the installed software. Suppose something is missing in your system and you just want to install that particular software, then just go to that terminal that I have shown you just in the next last class. Here you will just execute like sudo, then yum install install, then that's your call. Let's say tree command is not there, okay, then just go to the this particular terminal and type this. It will automatically download and install this tree command in your system, but in Windows it is not that much easy. Suppose you are going to install on some software, then that will take you some other particular tool, then that will take some other, finally you will reach at the policybazaar.com. Okay, so you are wanting to install some software, but it will take you that policybazaar.com. Okay, you might have seen many times, so you will not, that it is not that much easy to install a particular particular software, or it is not easy task to update your existing software also. But in Linux it is very easy. Okay, so in Linux you will just write like this, yum update, simple. Okay, it will update whatever softwares are there, it will upgrade. Okay, this is called simplified. Then lightweight means Linux OS is lightweight, means once you install your laptop in your operating system in your hard disk, so that when you will just press the power button, that particular OS is going to be loaded into RAM, right? So in Windows operating system also the same thing happens, but loading the Windows operating system into RAM and loading the Linux operating system into RAM, Linux operating system will occupy very less space, whereas Windows will occupy very high space. So as it is occupying very high space from the from your valuable RAM, then for your application program, it is not that for the application program, it will be, get very less space to run your application program. But in Linux, as the operating system is taking only very few space, then for your application programs, you are getting a lot of space inside the RAM. So lightweight, so that's why we are telling that the Linux is a lightweight operating system, means it will occupy very less space from your RAM, so that your application program can run easily. So then multi-user multitask with no limitation in Linux, but in Windows there is a limitation. Then you are telling getting that multiple distributions means, suppose you have a Windows laptop, Windows based laptop, means your laptop contains Windows based operating system. So suppose you have a Windows XP, then you must have the Windows kernel, and the operating system is called Windows XP, but kernel is Windows. Like this, here suppose I have a Fedora or I have a Ubuntu operating system, then the underlying kernel is called Linux. Okay, Ubuntu, Fedora, Red Hat, these are the flavors of this Linux OS, Linux based OS. So here I am just comparing with the ice creams. Okay, so Ubuntu is a Linux OS, then PC Linux OS, this is a Linux OS, Fedora is a Linux OS, CentOS is a Linux, okay, Suje is a Linux, then lot of things. Okay, so I didn't mention here the Red Hat also. Red Hat is also a Linux OS. So all these Linux, how they are different? The kernel is same. The kernel will be Linux kernel, which was developed by Linus Torvalds. That is same for all. But what the difference? Then small difference are there. Suppose Ubuntu is developing its own small software for user management, then some security management, then like Fedora is developing some other thing, then Red Hat is developing some other thing. So that way they are different, but according to kernel they are same. So kernel is same for all, so they are the Linux things. So Ubuntu is a Linux, Fedora is a Linux, everything, whatever picture I am showing here, they are all Linux. There are Ubuntu is a community, right? Fedora is a community, but Red Hat is a company. Okay, so somewhere I have written here that licensing is very costly, and here also I have read if you can purchase the paid version of Unix, depends on you. Okay, sometimes some people wants to buy the Linux product also, because this Ubuntu is a community version, it's totally free. If you are using free software, then if something will goes wrong, then you will not get that much support. But if you are purchasing some software, then obviously suppose Red Hat, from Red Hat you have purchased that Red Hat operating system, then obviously whatever issue is going on in that OS and in your application, immediately you are going to get a support from the Red Hat side, because you have purchased that particular product. But for free software, you are they are not responsible to give you that much support. Okay, you will just raise your query, then after 1 or 2 days you will get your answer. But if you are using Red Hat, then immediately you are going to get a support. Okay, then these are called the different companies or different communities which are providing you the Linux OS. That's why called lot of distributions are there. In Windows, very less distribution, hardly 4 to 5 distribution, but in Linux, a lot of, you can tell hundreds of flavors. Okay, like this. Then the shell, as I told here, shell is playing the main role, because we don't know kernel, we are not bother about the kernel, just we will give the command to the shell, shell will give us the output. So here the cell are of various types. So there are various types of cell depending upon the features they are supporting. Okay, so there are many cells like bash cell, CSS cell, KSS cell, JSS, and PC. JSS is a Mac cell. So this is my Mac laptop, guys. Okay, so in that Mac laptop, if you will ask the laptop to show your cell, So in the terminal only I can ask some question like echo dollar zero. If I'll ask this question, then it will bring you ZSH. Okay. If I am in the bash cell, let me go to the bash cell. So just type a BASH, it will take you into the bash cell. Okay. So here I am in the bash. So echo dollar zero is showing you the I am in the bash. Suppose I am going into KSH cell, KSH, then echo dollar zero, it is going to show you that KSH cell. Okay. How to come outside of this cell? Exit. I'm just exiting. Again, I am exiting. I will come to the default cell. So just type echo dollar zero. So I was in the ZSSL, right? So Mac has the ZSSL. So by default, every system has its own cell. Like Mac, it is a Mac system, and the terminal I have opened, it's a Mac terminal. That's why if I am typing this echo dollar zero, then it is going to give me ZSH. What are the cells available in this system? One particular system may contain multiple cells, but the choosing is depend upon you that which cell you are going to work. Okay, so by default it is ZSH. Suppose I am acquainted with the bash cell, then I will just change that bash. So before that, I should know what are the cells are available. So the command is cat slash etc slash shells. Okay, so if I am typing this command, just concentrate on this. What is that cat command? Don't worry, just type this whole command. I will tell you in detail what is echo, what is cat. Just execute this command and see what is that. But just execute this command, you will be able to see all the list of cells. Here it telling list of acceptable cells for CHPASS. Okay, then all these are the cells available in my system. Whatever cells I am acquainted, I can use. Suppose I am acquainted with bash. Dekho, yahan pe bash hai, CSH hai, dash hai, right? Guys, I may use some Hindi or English language. Okay, it is not purely English or purely Hindi. To better discussion, because the India people are talking in Hindi, right? So sometimes some Hindi may come from my side. Okay, so Hindi or English, I will discuss everything in the mixed language. So here, as I told, cat class it is class cells, it is going to display all the number of cells present in my particular system. So whatever this system, that like my, this is my Mac system. Inside this Mac system, I have installed all these cells. So somebody is wanting to work in bash cell, then just press BASH, it will take you into the bash cell. Then you can see whether you are reached at that cell or not. Echo dollar zero, then you are able to see bash. Yes, I am in the bash cell. Then suppose I want to come to the default cell, then exit, just do exit, and I will be directly go to the my default cell, echo dollar zero at the ZSS. So I just discussed today till this what are the types of cells, like bash cells, CSS cells. So why these type of cell? Different companies has developed the different cells to show up them. Yeah, this is, I have developed this cell. So like this, okay. So you can use any of the cell. For many of the cell, commands are same. Okay, whatever commands you are running in the bash, the same command will also going to work in the KSS. Same command is going to work in the ZSS, everywhere. Okay, these are the cells. So I just wanted to demonstrate that. So you know, right? Cell is like this sunk, this coda, right? This type of cells. So I am just in Linux, the cells name is called bash, KSH, CSH, ZSS. So if you are opening one terminal, just see this. I am closing this in the Mac. So I am here just clicking this particular thing. It is showing you the terminal. Okay. So in this terminal, you will type the command. And this particular command is going to be executed by a particular cell. That cell name is called echo dollar zero. This ZSH, okay? Echo dollar zero will show you the cell name. So this is the cell which is going to execute your date command, echo command, cal command. Okay. So I hope you guys understood, right, up to this. These are the theory part, guys. So again, tomorrow I am going to discuss the practical part, how to interact with the system, how to install the Linux, whether we will install the Linux in our system, yeah, you will rent that Linux from somewhere. I'll discuss one by one tomorrow. So guys, till that, if you have any question, please ask me today. And just go through my all these videos carefully and prepare a note. If you are not preparing the note, then it's very big demerit, guys. So always read my go through my video and keep a notebook inside in the side of you. Then just whatever things you are learning from this video, just type it out in your notebook. Okay, just note it out, so that it will help you during the interview time or any time. It can help. So if nothing, if no doubt is there from your side, I would like to close this session. Okay, guys, bye for that time.